Hello class! Welcome back to our channel. So for today's video, our topic is all about continuity at a number. So ano bang ibig sabihin ng isang continuous function? So a function is continuous when its graph is a single unbroken curve. Okay, so that you could draw without lifting your pen from the paper. So example, may given tayong graph dito sa baba. Okay, so as you can see, pag drinon natin, yung graph guys, is hindi natin kailangan itaas yung ating pen. Tama? And at the same time, yung ating graph is unbroken. So that means this graph or this function is continuous. Okay? So a function f of x is said to be continuous at the number a if all of the following three conditions are satisfied. So, ang first condition natin, f of a exist. Okay, yung a natin dito, ito yung ating number. Okay, then ang second condition natin, the limit of f of x as x approaches a is also exist. Then, ang third condition natin is the limit of the function as x approaches a is equals doon sa ating f of a. Okay, so if any of the following or if any one of the above three conditions fail, the function f of x is said to be discontinuous at the number a. Okay, so let's have our first example. So determine whether f of x is equals to 4x squared plus x minus 2 is continuous at x equals 1. So again, ang first step natin is i-check muna natin if f of a or yung f of 1 natin exist. So, try natin. So, ang f of 1 natin is ang gagawin nyo lang guys is just substitute yung ating 1 dito sa ating function. Okay? Then sa 4x squared plus x minus 2. So, yung dalawang x natin dito sa ating function magiging 1. Okay? Then simplify natin guys. So, 4 times 1 square plus 1 minus 2. So, ang sagot natin dito is positive 3. So, nasatisfy natin yung first condition. Yung f of a natin exist. Okay? So, next, check naman natin yung limit. So, the limit of 4x square plus x minus 2 as x approaches 1. So, since polynomial naman yung ating function dito. So, pwede tayong mag-direct substitution ng 1. Tama? So, try natin. We have 4y squared plus 1 minus 2. So, ang sagot natin dito is positive 3. So, nasatisfy natin yung second condition. The limit of f of x as x approaches a exists. Nakuha? Then, dun tayo sa third condition, guys. So, as you can see, yung ating limit ng function as x approaches 1 is equal doon sa ating f of 1. Tama? Pareha silang positive 3. So, therefore, the function is continuous at x equals 1. Naintindihan ba, guys? So, try natin i-examine yung kanyang graph. So, ito yung ating given function. Okay? Then, yung number natin is x equals 3, tama? Ay, x equals 1. So, ito yung ating given function kanina. So, nandito yung x equals 1 natin. So, as you can see, continuous yung ating function doon sa ating given number. Okay, so ito yung 1 natin. So, nandito siya sa may bandang 1, 3. Nakuha, guys? So, let's have another example. Number 2, determine whether f of x is equals to x squared minus 9 over x minus 3 is continuous at x equals 0, x equals 2, and x equals 3. So, tatlo yung pinagagawa sa atin dito or tatlo yung pinapacheck na number. Okay, so unahin natin yung at x equals 0. So, first, evaluate natin yung ating function. when x is equals to 0. So, yung dalawang x natin dito, guys, sa ating function, magiging 0. Then, compute lang natin, 0 square minus 9 all over 0 minus 3. So, this is negative 9 over negative 3, and that is positive 3. Tama? So, yung ating f of a exists. Nasatisfy natin yung first condition. Next, check natin yung kanyang limits. So, the limit of x square minus 9 over x minus 3 as x approaches 0. Okay, so try natin. So, since di naman tayo magkakaroon ng undefined sa denominator, so, pwede tayong or hindi naman magiging 0 yung ating denominator, so, pwede tayong mag-direct substitution. Tama? So, substitute natin yung 0 natin dito sa ating function. So, we have 0 square minus 9 over 0 minus 3. So, this is also negative 9 over negative 3. So, ang limit ni x square minus 9 over x minus 3 as x approaches to 0 is 3. Okay? So, nasatisfy natin yung second condition, yung limit ng function natin exists. Okay? So, then yung third condition natin, so since the limit of a function as x approaches 0 is equal doon sa ating f of 1 or f of 0, guys, eto, sa may taas, di ba? So, 3 equals 3 sila. So, therefore, the function is continuous at x equals 0. Okay? So, next, try naman natin yung at x equals 2. So, applying the same procedure, evaluate muna natin yung ating function when x equals 2. So, direct substitution lang yan, guys. We have 2 square minus 9 over 2 minus 3. Okay, so pag sinolve natin yan, meron tayong negative 5 dito sa taas over negative 1. So, negative 5 divided by negative 1. So, ang sagot natin dito is positive 5. Okay? So, next, yung ating limit naman. The limit of a function as x approaches 2. So, since di naman tayo magkakaroon ng 0 sa ating denominator, so, pwede tayong mag-direct substitution. Tama? So, finding the limits, we have 2 square minus 9 over 2 minus 3. So, pag sinolve natin to, guys, we have 4 minus 9, that is negative 5, over 2 minus 3, that's negative 1. So, negative 5 divided by negative 1, sagot natin dito is positive 5. Okay, so therefore, the limit exists at x approaches 2. Okay, so as you can see, guys, yung limit natin dito ng ating function as x approaches 2 is equals doon sa ating f of 2. Pareha silang 5. Tama? So, therefore, the function is continuous at x equals 2. Okay? So, next, try naman natin yung at x equals 3. So, dito, guys, as you can see, pagka nag-evaluate tayo ng ating function when x is equals to 3, yung denominator and numerator natin parehas magiging 0. Diba? So, we have 3 squared, that's 9 minus 9, 0. Then, 3 minus 3, 0. So, yung f of x natin is indeterminate. Okay? So, next, check naman natin yung ating limits. So, yung limit ng ating function as x approaches 3. So, dito guys, hindi tayo pwedeng mag-direct substitution kasi nga, magkakaroon tayo ng indeterminate. Tama? So, ang gagawin natin, bago natin makuha yung limit ng ating function is, ipa-factor muna natin si x squared minus 9. And that is x minus 3 over x plus 3. Times x plus 3. Tama? Same lang naman yan. Then, after natin ma-factor, makikita natin dito na common si x minus 3 sa numerator and denominator. So, maka-cancel out yan. So, ang bagong function natin is x plus 3. So, this time, pwede na natin makuha yung ating limits. So, pag sinubstitute natin si 3 dito, we have 3 plus 3. So, ang limit ng ating function as x approaches 3 is positive 6. Okay? So, this time guys, yung limit ng ating function as x approaches 3 is not equal doon sa ating f of 3. Tama? Meron tayong 6, tapos meron tayong indeterminate. So, ibig sabihin, di natin na-satisfied yung third condition. So, ano ngayon yan? The function is discontinuous at x equals 3. Nakuha guys? So, saan lang siya continuous? Kay 0 and positive 2. Then, pagdating kay 3, discontinuous na yung ating function. Okay, so examine natin yung graph. So, ito yung guys yung graph ng ating f of x, x square minus 9 over x minus 3. Okay, as you can see, meron tayong straight line dyan. Pagka drino natin yung ating function sa Cartesian plane. So, dito guys, sa 0, kung mapapansin nyo, yung ating function kay x equals 0 is continuous pa. Tama? Then, kay 2, kung mapapansin nyo, still continuous. Kailan lang tayo nagkaroon ng discontinuous? Pagpunta natin kay x equals 3. Diba? So, since indeterminate yung ating x equals 3, nagkaroon ng hole yung ating graph. Okay? So, ibig sabihin, pag nag-draw tayo ng straight line, pagdating dito sa hole, ililift natin yung pen natin. Diba? Ang definition kanina, ang continuous function, madadraw natin yung graph without lifting our pen. So, this time, may tumalon or may butas. Tama? So, ibig sabihin, yung ating graph is discontinuous, or yung ating function is discontinuous at x equals 3. Okay? So, let's have another example. So, investigate the continuity of the function f of x is equals to negative 2x plus 4 if x is greater than or equal to 3. Then, x minus 1 naman yung ating function if x is less than 3. Okay? So, again, ang first step natin is i-evaluate natin yung ating function at x equals 3. So, kukunin natin si f of 3. Okay? So, since ang value ng ating x is positive 3, ang gagamitin nating function is yung negative 2x plus 4. Kasi yung domain ng 3 is included dito. Okay? Nandun yung greater than or equal. Okay? Yung equals natin. So, by direct substitution, that is negative 2 times 3 plus 4. So, we have negative 6 plus 4. So, this is negative 2. Tama? Next, kunin natin yung ating limits. So, ang limit ng ating function as x approaches 3 from the right, ang from the right natin, guys, yung greater than. Ito. Okay? So, ang gagamitin natin function is yung negative 2x plus 4. So, pag sinubstitute natin yung 3 dito sa ating function, we have negative 2 times 3, that is negative 6 plus 4, this is negative 2. Tama? Then, kunin naman natin yung limit ng ating function from the left. Okay? As x approaches 3 from the left. Ang from the left natin, guys, yung less than. Diba? Ito yung mga values ng x less than 3. So, ibig sabihin, ang gagamitin natin function is yung x minus 1. Nakuha ba? So, ibig sabihin, pag sinubstitute natin si 3, dito sa ating function na x minus 1, meron tayong 3 minus 1. So, the limit of x minus 1 as x approaches 3 from the left is positive 2. Okay? So, dito guys, kung mapapansin nyo, yung limit ng ating function is iba dun sa from the right and from the left. Okay? Sa from the right, meron tayong negative 2. Dun sa may from the left, meron tayong positive 2. Ibig sabihin, yung limit ng ating function does not exist. Okay? So, hindi natin na-satisfied yung ating second condition. Tama? since yung limit natin does not exist. So hence, the function discontinuous at x equals 3. Nakuha ba? So meron tayong discontinuous tayo. Okay? So, tignan natin yung graph. So ito yung graph ng ating function. So as you can see, from the right, okay, as x, if x is greater than or equal to 3, papunta tayo dito. Okay, ito yun. Then, dun sa may from the left, okay, so ito yung graph natin dito, yung x minus 1. So, as you can see guys, pag drain na natin yung ating function, parang may jump. Diba? So, may tatalon tayo dito. Ibig sabihin, kung may talon yan or putol, discontinuous yung ating function. Nakuha ba? So, let's have another example, number 4. Investigate the continuity of the function f of x is equals to the absolute value of x plus 1 if x is not equals to negative 1. Then, yung function natin is equals to 3 if x is equals to negative 1. Okay? So, try natin to guys. Solution at x equals negative 1. So, ang f of negative 1 natin, since ang value ng ating x is negative 1, so, ang f of negative 1 natin is constant, yung positive 3. Nakuha? Ito yung gagamitin natin, yung 3. So, next, pag kinuha naman natin yung limit, guys. So, since the absolute value of a number is the distance of the number from 0. Tama? So, dito guys, we have to satisfy both cases from the right and from the left because the argument of an absolute value function is maybe positive or negative. Okay? So, ganyan lagi gagawin natin guys ha, pag meron tayong absolute value. So, evaluate natin yung limit. So, dito guys, i-assume natin na positive yung ating function. So, direct substitution, meron tayong negative 1 plus 1. So, that is 0. Okay? So, yung limit ng ating function as x approaches negative 1 from the right is 0. Then, dito naman sa may from the left, meron tayong negative 1 din. Okay? So, direct substitution lang tayo. We have negative 1 plus 1, that is 0, times negative, still 0. Okay, so therefore, the limit exists. Ang limit ng ating function is 0. Okay, yun nga lang, pagdating natin sa third condition, yung limit natin, which is 0, is not equal to f of negative 1. Kasi ang f of negative 1 natin is positive 3. Tama guys? So, therefore, the function is discontinuous at x equals negative 1. Nakuha, guys? So, examine natin yung kanyang graph. Ito yung graph ng ating function. So, as you can see, yung graph ng ating the absolute value of x plus 1 if x is not equal to negative 1 is ito. Okay? So, meron tayong hole dito. Bakit kaya tayo nagka-hole dito? Kasi guys, if x is equals to negative 1, ang value ng ating f of x is positive 3. So, ibig sabihin, dito natin makikita yung ating point if x is equals to negative 1. Tama? Kasi ang kanyang y is equals to positive 3 according dito sa ating function. Okay? So, again, may jump na naman or may hole na naman tayo. So, yung graph natin is discontinuous. Okay? So, proceed tayo kay number 5. Investigate the continuity of the function f of x equals, the function is equals to 4x minus 2 if x is less than or equals to 2. Okay? Then, if x is greater than 2, yung function natin is equals to negative 2x plus 5. So, ang first step natin, evaluate natin guys muna si f of 2. So since ang domain natin na 2 is na kay 4x minus 2, siya yung may equals dito guys. Okay, so direct substitution yan. So 4 times 2, that is 8 minus 2. So ang f of 2 natin is equals to 6. Okay, so check natin yung limit ngayon. So, una, yung from the right natin, ito yun guys, yung greater than, x greater than 2, ito yung from the right, tandaan, no? So, ang gagamitin natin is negative 2x plus 5. So, pag kinuha natin yung limit ng ating function as x approaches 2 from the right, so substitute natin yan, we have negative 2 times 2, so this is negative 4 plus 5, so ang sagot natin is positive 1. Then, dun naman sa may from the left, ang gagamitin natin yung less than. Nandito, guys. So, pagka less than 2 yung ating x, ang function natin is equals to 4x minus 2. Okay? So, substitute natin si 2 dito. So, we have 4 times 2, that is 8, minus 2, that is positive 6. So, dito, guys, yung limit natin from the right is not equal dun sa limit from the left. Ibig sabihin, yung limit ng ating function does not exist. Okay? So, kung hindi natin masasatisfy yung second condition, ibig sabihin, the function discontinuous at x equals 2. Okay? So, tignan natin yung graph. So, ito yung graph ng ating function. So, as you can see, yung graph ng 4x minus 2, if x is less than or equal to 2, ito siya. Okay? Then, yung graph ng ating x greater than 2, nandito. So, pag tinignan nyo yung function natin, pag drino natin, may jump na naman. Diba? So, since nag-jump tayo dito, ibig sabihin, yung function natin is discontinuous. Okay? So, naintindihan ba guys yung ating topic? So, this is the end of our lesson. I hope naintindihan nyo guys kung ano bang ibig sabihin ng continuous function. So, if you have questions or clarifications, kindly put them in the comment section below. So, thank you guys for watching. This is Prof. D. I'll catch you on the flip side. Bye!